neck triangle. Our head hosts our brain, which directs and coordinates most of the things happening in our body. The bridge that connects our head to other parts of our body is our neck. It contains numerous nerves, blood vessels, muscles, and many other parts. That is why understanding neck anatomy is important. Imagine if, during a crucial neck surgery for a patient, you incise the wrong part in the wrong location. The patient's time or lifespan may have been wasted. With the help of this video, you would be able to understand the neck triangles easily. First, as the baseline, determine the middle line of your neck. Then, locate the clavicle for the limit of the lower part. Next, locate the mandible bone above. Finally, locate the trapezius muscle behind. This is the area we will focus on. Now, the sternocleidomastoid muscle will divide the area into two major triangles, the anterior and posterior. Going deeper, these major parts can be divided again. For starters, locate the hyoid bone. The digastric muscle will attach to it. It is divided into the anterior belly and the posterior belly. The triangle between both digastric muscles will be submandibular triangle, and the triangle between the middle line of the neck and the anterior digastric will be the submental triangle. From the hyoid bone, the omohyoid muscle will also arise and go behind the sternocleidomastoid muscle until it reaches the back part of the neck. The anterior belly of the omohyoid muscle will give us two more triangles, the carotid triangle, which is located above the anterior belly, and the muscular triangle, which is located below the anterior belly. Next, the posterior belly of the omohyoid muscle will divide the posterior area into two triangles, the occipital triangle, which is located above the posterior belly, and the supraclavicular, which is located below. So, in total, we have six triangles in our necks. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is the triangles in our neck.